Please welcome to the stage Matt Gordon.
Glad you could all come out tonight. We're going to have a little fun here. I came up for a visit last summer to be in the Mission Folk Festival, and I kind of fell in love with this place. You've really got some nice things going on here. And it rains a little bit more than I'm used to, but it's other than that, it's been great. Francis was down visiting where I lived in Annapolis, Maryland, years ago, and I'd converted a chicken coop into a little dance studio and a woodworking shop, and he saw a tunable dance floor that I built into the floor there, and he was kind of scratching his head and looking at it and didn't say a whole lot about it. And it wasn't until about 10 years later I saw him at a festival in Europe, and he said, "Matt, God, I haven't seen you in a long time. Listen, I think the Mission Folk Festival needs one of those tunable dance floors." I was like, "Oh yeah? Okay, that sounds like fun." So long story short, I got a chance to come up and actually do it. And that's what you're looking at right now. It's in several pieces at the moment. Let's see if I can explain this. I'll try to do it off mic and show you while I'm...
Can you hear me all right?
Yeah.
All right. So basically what we got here is three different drums. And they've got volume on the side here, the back, the top. And they're made out of plywood. And it's basically a resonator box, which means that when you bang on the top, the whole box will resonate. Now, there's an extra element in here that allows you to adjust the sound and actually tune the vibration of the box. And the way we figured out how to do that was this piece here is a flying bridge. I won't get too technical on you, but this goes to the two sides, okay? Now this piece is got a wedge on the bottom of it, and as you move it that way, it pushes on the wedge, which pushes on these two braces that are on the bottom of the floor itself. So as you move that, the tension of the floor increases. And therefore, it's like tensioning a drum. Like when you play a boron, you can put your hand back there. I don't know if any of you are familiar with that. So that's the basic principle. And these have a dual purpose. They not only hold the dance floor up and adjust the tension, but they also bring the sound down through the braces, through the spring plate here, and then across the flying bridge. Just in case you want to build one in your backyard. And so there's three different boxes. And this is the frame. It's just a frame designed to fit these. And there's little bits of rubber inlaid into the wood there so that each box sits independently of the other ones. So when you bang on one, not all three of them start vibrating. It's three distinct different sounds. So it's like three different drums in a frame. And it's pretty simple. It just fits right together. With generally a little bit of persuasion, it looks something like this. So that's the middle one. Oh, this, by the way, is the tuning stick. Now. This fits into the, this allows you to tune it without having to crawl underneath it when it's on the ground. It should have to be pretty skinny to do that. So this fits in here and allows you to move the tuning mechanism back and forth, if that makes any sense. Okay. All right, enough pyrotechnics here. Let's put it together and have a little fun. Thank you.
Bye.